Hello YouTube, this is Chen the Design Maker. Welcome to my channel for designing and making cool stuff. So if it's your first time here, please subscribe for future awesome videos. Today we're gonna learn how to use L298N and Arduino to drive some motors and make this weird looking robot. The L298N is a motor driver that can PWM control two DC motors or one stepper motor. It is widely used for robotic projects such as the one I'm working on right now, so don't forget to check it out. The module is very affordable and the link is in the description below. So without further ado, let's get started. Take a close look at this module. The biggest part with the heatsink on is actual L298N chip. The front terminal blocks are for the input and output of the power. The 12 volt is for driving the motor and the 5 volt is for the logics. Think it as a faucet with a two directional valve. The 12 terminal are the water running through the pipe and the 5 volt is like a force controlling the valve. Two sets of terminal blocks on both sides are for the two DC motors with very straightforward connections. And at last, there are six pins at front are used to control the motors. How does this module control the motors? The two pins with jumpers on both ends are motor enable pins. Leave the jumper on or connect to high voltage level means full throttle. Get the jumper pins removed or connect to low logic level, the motor will be parked. If PWM is feeding to these pins, you get yourself a speed control. The rest of the four pins are like the gear shifter, switching between driving and reversing. Refer to this chart to see how they work. Let's look at some examples. If we're driving these 6-volt motors, power is needed for both the driving and the logic. Here I connected to 4 AA batteries into the 12-volt and ground terminals, and also a jumper to connect both 12 and 5-volt. A really quick way to test your module is using one of these male to female cable. Since we have motor A connected, just connect the IN1 and 5 volt, you'll see the motor start running. Move the pin to IN2, it starts to reverse. If you are driving bigger 12 volt motors like this one, you can connect the motor the same way, with a simpler power connection. Just plug in your power source to the 12 volt and ground. Here, I'm using a stripped 12-volt power supply. The onboard 78MO5 voltage regulator can step down anything between 7 to 12 volt to 5, so that it not only provides the logic needed from the L298N, but also meet the 5-volt terminal and output. We can use the same technique to test the motor. You can use a 5-volt terminal to power Arduino as well. For any motor needs more than 12 volts up to 24, it is recommended to remove this jumper pin to disable the onboard 78MO5. To control the motor with Arduino, we'll just connect the 6 controlling pins to Arduino digital pins. Make sure the enable A and enable B are connected to PWM pins for speed control later. Here we're connecting the 6 pins to Arduino digital pin 5 to 10. Now we got everything connected. The two motors go into the motor terminals thanks to the support from this awesome helping hand. 4 AA batteries connect to the 12 and ground, also a jumper pin to bridge the 12 and 5. Arduino is connected as well. One last thing, since I'm powering the Arduino from the USB with a computer, it needs to share a ground with the batteries. Just simply connect the ground on Arduino and a ground terminal on the module. Let's start the Arduino programming. Starting from the most straightforward code. The first step is to define all the pin numbers. During the setup, we define all the pin to output modes, then assign them default values so they stay stuck. In the loop, we can just analog write a PWM value from 0 to 255 to control the speed. The bigger the value, the faster the motor runs. And we also digital write in 1 and 2 to control the motor directions. Don't forget to add a delay in it. But if you're going to control the motor a lot with different direction or speed, such as driving a path, this would be too much work. You'll have to repeat this paragraph over and over again. It's not efficient at all. Here's a simpler version. I defined a motor class here that holds all the pin information. It has a drive method that takes one speed variable to drive the motor. If it's from 0 to 255, the motor will drive forward. If it's 0 to negative 255, it will drive backwards. Once we have the two motors defined before the setup, we can control the speed and direction with one line of code just using the drive function. You can make your own functions by combining multiple motors too. The full code can be found in the description. Hope this tutorial is helpful for your next project. Let me know if you have any questions and what you're gonna build with this. Thanks for watching, and if you like my video, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time!